and both Sun, Moon, and Rising, I want to say thank you for being here. Thank you for being back. And thank you for supporting my channel. Okay. All right. For this month of July, I'm dedicating this month of July to someone, a wonderful person who has supported this channel. This month is dedicated to Sadie. Hey you. And this is she supports our channel in the sense that she's also a subscriber, and she has blessed us with a lot of cards, and she's hoping that I will and asking to keep these general readings going. So thank you, Sadie. Thank you so much. Thanks to all the other people that has supported my channel in whatever way. Thank you for your donation and for the wonderful support that you have been doing. Thank you for the comments also. You have gave me valuable idea. I know exactly when people are looking out for the weekly readings and that sort of a thing. So again, Sadie, thank you so much. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, Sadie has donated, and we have got this, and I love this deck. It is a very nice, simple deck. I thought of her when I was choosing this deck, because she's just so a wonderful person, but simply nothing to hide. This deck basically say who Sadie is. Wonderful, a lot of energy, a lot of stars. She is a helping person, and this is a wonderful deck. The thing about this new deck is the Ka, the K-A. If you look at my channel, it is Kathye Kaan, Ka and Kaan, Ka. And the Ka is the zeal and the healing of the soul. So when I saw this deck, I'm like, oh my God, this is really her personality. A very bubbly, nothing to hide, and that sort of a thing. So again, Sadie, thank you. We also have, and most of the decks that is going to be used in this month reading and next month reading, I'm going to be using the decks that the donation that Sadie gave us. These are the decks that are going to be using. Okay, so I am asking each and everyone, you know, to send blessings for Sadie, and blessings and healing for Sadie. I guess she is also one of our soul family. So thank you for supporting Sadie, and welcome to our group. Okay, all right. This month is the month of the Hierophant. So a lot of people will be dealing with legalities and that sort of a situation in this month. Energy of the High Princess comes up. So listen to your intuition. You guys listen to your intuition. Okay, the energy of the High Princess comes up. And what this is saying is that the angels and your guides in angels are going to be trying to connect with you in this month. So open up yourself to the information that is coming out. It is the energy of the Hierophant. The energy of the Hierophant is a wonderful, fabulous, you know, month that is going to be showing you wonderful experience and wonderful situations that is going to be coming in. Okay, what is happening in this month also is that the two first weeks is a more emotional weeks, and the two last week is more fire, passion. Okay, so let's look at the reading for the Capricorns, and let's see what is happening for the Capricorns in the month of July. So we're calling up on the angel. In the first week, you have some regrets. Okay, whatever the situation is, and whatever is the regrets in the first week, some of you Capricorns have some regrets. Okay, let's move on and see what these regrets are. What is it, the energy in the second week of July for the Capricorns? So the Knight of Pentacles. So you Capricorns between the ages of 25 and 45, is going to be having some regrets. Okay, so you are the ones who came in the month of June with regrets. So I'm calling up in the angels and guides. What is here for the Capricorns for the month of July? There's an ending. There's an ending and a transition. And this is good. So whatever is happening, if some of you, and be careful, because I'm seeing you Knight of Pentacles having regrets. So you people between the ages of 25 and 45, you're going to be having some regrets, okay? This looks like it's a knight. So let's go further to see, because there's an ending. The regrets could be ended, but you could be, and you know, you're listening to yourself. Let's see what's coming out in the fourth week. The Nine of Pentacles. Okay, so this is wonderful. This is good. This is positive. A wonderful, 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 wonderful situation. Wonderful situation. Wonderful, positive situation. Okay. And you guys are saying, what is she seeing so wonderful and positive? Okay, all right, let me explain. You have only one major arcana, and this major arcana is in the third week. It has to do with your work. So let's see. Some of you, who are you guys, is the people between the age of 25 and 45, begins the month, coming out of June, begins the month of July. The first week of July has something to do with a legal case. And with a legal case. Now, if you're a lawyer, be aware of the first week. If you have a legal case in the first week, do some extra research on this case, because if you don't, you're going to be having this regret. But we're going to look forward to see, because the first week of July is a situation with a legal case, okay? Because it's justice. The general energy is justice. And some of you are having regrets, okay? So if you're a lawyer or someone who is intervening in a conflict, be aware of what happened in the first week, because the week is the energy of justice. Second week, the people between the ages of 25 and 40, 45 could be, you know, going inwards and looking at themselves, And the third week, there is an ending coming to, if you're working, there could be an ending coming, but you're going to receive a huge payout. Okay, so the third week of July, you could be ending your job and moving on to a new job, or you could be ending a situation and moving on to a situation. If you lose a case, or it's a bittersweet, but whatever's coming to an end, the Nine of Pentacles, you're going to be receiving a lot of money, financial stability. I couldn't tell when the last I see this energy for the Nine of Pentacles coming up for the Capricorn. So let's go deeper and look and see exactly what is happening and what is transpiring. Okay, so we're asking the angels to show us what is going to be happening in the first week of July 2018, going in the second week. Heartbreaks. Okay, let's see what's going in for the Capricorns, Sun, Moon, and Rising Capricorns, and the second week going in the third week. The energy of the Tower. There's an ending. It could be an ending of a loss that is coming in. And I'm seeing this is affecting the people between the ages of 25 and 35. That's who it's affecting. Okay, what else is happening for the Capricorns, third week going to 4 weeks. What is happening? Third week's going into the Two of Cups. Wonderful situation. Okay, it's a bittersweet month for you guys. It's a bittersweet because there's some regrets, there's a loss for the people, some of the people between the ages of 25 and 45. You guys are, there's an ending that is coming, a swift ending that is coming, okay? And with the swift ending, there is going to be an ending with someone, and it could be a relationship, but we're going to be looking to see what exactly is that. And a relationship that has the connection. We have the Emperor. We have the Emperor. We have the Emperor. So it could be ending to work. Okay. Let's see the Tower and the Two of Cups. What is... Okay. Stab in the back. Someone at your work. Be careful about someone at your work, you Capricorns. Because obviously, someone at your work could be stabbing you in the back. Someone at your work could be stabbing you in your back. Wow, Capricorns. Someone at your work could be stabbing you in the back. Okay, we're asking the angels and guides to show us what is the outcome for the month of July. For the Capricorn Sun, Moon, and Rising sign. The Star. Okay. All right, guys. Stop giving me a heart attack. 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 Ace of Cups. Okay. Two of Cups and Ace of Cups. So new love. We have an understanding that new love is coming in. Okay. There is a situation where new love is coming in. Okay. So what is happening here is that we have the Tower energy. In the middle of the month, okay, the Tower energy is that some of you, and this is what I'm seeing, some of you, there's a Tower energy about a lot of lies, being stabbed in the back, and this is by a relationship. This is by a relationship. You've been stabbed in the back door, someone, and this is. And the situation is that there's a new love that came in. Okay, so some of you connected with someone. And what happened is that you felt stabbed in the back by this person. And the Knight of Pentacles is here. So it could be some of you have been stabbing, because we're not seeing where this is coming from, and we're going to do the work has a situation. Some of you between the ages of 25 and 45 is going to be stabbed in the back by someone at your work, your supervisor, your partner, someone, some person is going to be stabbing you in your back at work. There's going to be a lot of lies and stuff that is going on at work. Okay, some of you, new love is coming in. New love is coming in. Whoever this person is financial stability. Okay, so new love is going to be coming in. Whoever this person is going to be financial stability. There's a lot of stability in this person's life. This is going to be a love that is going to go for a while. But work situation is not looking good for you Capricorns. Your boss is going to be stabbing you in your back. But anyway, you come out to be the energy of the Star, okay? So I need to ask something. Please show us what is going to be the energy. What is happening under this energy vibration? I'm seeing new love coming in. That is good. I'm seeing new love coming in. Okay, please show us the energy for the Capricorn for the month of July. Energy of the sun. So, the energy of the star and the sun. So, please show us what exactly that has been going on. It doesn't really matter what, who. Okay, ladies, be aware. Ladies, be aware. Some of you ladies are going to be receive the energy of a stable foundation. Okay, so that is good. News is going to be coming in of the ending of a karmatic situation. Oh my God, love is in the air. Oh, you know, I can't sing, but every time I see this card, I start singing, and I can't sing. Listen, work situation, people are going to be stabbing you in the back, but love is here to stay, honey. Okay, come on. Let's see what is going to be the ending outcomes of this month of July. The month of July for the Capricorn Sun, Moon, and Rising sign. Okay, all the blockage that was there is being lifted, and there is new opportunities coming in. And whatever, because I'm having the energy, is the end of a karmatic situation for the ladies. And see, some of you ladies are going to be connecting with the love of your life. And some of you ladies are going to be connecting with good friends. Okay, so you're losing a situation in your life that has to do with work, but the outcomes is the energy of the star and the sun, and you will be regaining new friendship. A new friendship is coming in. Some of you, it's new friendship. Some of you is a new love, and this is a soulmate relationship. So I am just so loving this. So at the end of July, some of you are going to be meeting your soulmate. This is new love coming in for you, and this person, whoever this person is, this person is and has money. Okay, this person has money, so this is going to be good. So new love is coming in. Some of you, it's coming in soulmate relationships, and some of it's coming in friendship. Okay, what I'm seeing here is happening and is transpiring. Which I need to ask, what, because I'm seeing the seven, I'm seeing these two energy, because whenever I put on the new love, the Knight of Wands, whoever this Knight of Wands is, it's a little he's trying to steal something or get away with something, whatever that is there, you know. Someone who is the Knight of Wands, be careful of who is this person. It's a ram. Whoever the Knight of Wands is, this person is trying to steal something and get away with it. So let's look at the situation. The Rat and the Seven of Swords. What is this all about? It's something about work. Something about work and a new start. Okay. Something about work and a new start. Be careful of your posts. You know, it's whatever the situation is, it has to do with work and a new start. Because and let me look at this. You know, you Capricorns always let me go over. So new love is coming in, and this new love is going to come in the form of past life relationships, friendships, and for some people it's going to come in your twin flame or soulmate is coming in. The energy for the ladies, whatever you karmatic situation, whatever hurt, whatever pain you were dealing with, it's going to be over But there is definitely something happening to your work in this week. Be aware and be careful of the situation that is happening, because there is something that is happening in your work in this week. Okay. Is there any other messages that we should end this month? Sorry. For the Capricorns. Okay. Conflicts. Five of Swords. The Empress. Conflicts about your materialistic, and you're having balance with the situation. Okay, so you're having balance with your materialistic, you know, there's conflicts about what you have and that sort of a thing, and you're trying to balance out that. So the energy of the Lovers. Oh my. So you Capricorns, expect love in the last week of July. As like a powerful love, this is a love to last a lifetime. But work, whatever the situation with your work, it's not very good. It's not very good. But love is here to stay for you, ladies. Love is here to stay. There is a situation that is going on with your work. There's a lot of hate and that sort of a thing that is going on. But not to worry. You know, and especially with your work and a new start for your work, not to worry about that, because what is basically happening and what is basically transpiring is that you are going to be okay. All right. So we are using another deck, the Crystal deck, and this is an healing deck. And with this healing deck, we are going to be looking at certain situations with this healing deck. So let's see what is happening. You have the Diamond. Oh, value your self-worth. You are God's picture. Your God precious gem. Isn't this wonderful? Capricorn, schools to you all. You're all God special gem. Value your self-worth. You are God's special gem. So each and every one of you Capricorns, no matter what you're going on with, no matter what you're going through, value your self-worth, because you are God's special gem. You are the special gem of the universe. Because I'm always saying this to you Capricorns. I'm always saying that Capricorns and the earth sign people are here on this planet to do a job, to do a work. And as you value your self-worth, you are God's precious gem. You need to understand that. So self-worth is going to be the situation for this month. I'm loving this. It's fabulous. So ladies and gentlemen, I'm wishing you a wonderful month. Work situation is going to be a lot of lies, backstabbing, and that sort of a thing. But new love is going to be coming in soulmate relationship and also in friendship. The energy of the Tower comes with the mirror energy of an end to our times. Okay, so the Tower and this, the general energy for the month of July is going to be an end that has come to hard times, a hand that has come to hard times. So whoever you are out there, whatever is going on, and whoever you are out there, what is going to be happening is that, especially for the people between the ages of 25 to 45, I'm getting 25 to 45, and you know, if you're lawyers out there, be aware. If you're lawyers out there, be aware, you're going to be regretting a situation with a case that you're dealing with. And you could be careful. The third week, there is going to be an ending coming to your work situation in the third week. For some of you, okay, I'm seeing this coming up. But the 4th week money is going to be coming to you, and love. Nine of Pentacles and the love, the energy of love is together. So this is going to be good. 17, 31, 4, 4. The number 4 energy is as if you have the energy of the high priestess. The energy of the high priestess is bringing in the angels, the guiding angels. So you're going to be very much protected, okay? There's a message that is going to be coming to some of you to say that this ending is coming. An ending of a karmatic situation is coming, and there's a lot of new opportunities that are going to be opening up. The energy of the anchor is here to bring you stability in your life, but also in your love life. Be aware of a work situation, someone trying to steal either your idea or your work. Be aware of this. And if that was for me, I know exactly where that is happening. That other YouTube readers are doing that. Be aware of the people around you. Be aware of the people at work who are around you. I'm not liking that situation for you. Keep yourself away from these people. Okay, whatever is happening on the work floor, because it is in the third week. The third week, there is a swift ending that is going to be coming in. It could be some of you, if your father is sick or that sort of a thing, in the third week, he could be passing over. Because I'm seeing him leaving the Nine of Pentacles in the fourth week. And this was someone who you love very much. But their message is saying to you, value your self-worth. Value your self-worth, because you are a precious gem to them. So this came back. This came back as I was about to close the reading. Is that in the third week, because debt and the general energy of the third week has to do with your boss, the emperor in the general readings. And you have the energy in the third week of debt and transformation, okay? So if your father's sick, there could be a situation, because I'm seeing here the rat with the seven of swords and the fox. So it's as if someone is taken away out of your life. You can also read it at is this that the ending, because it makes you stressful. An ending, the seven of swords. Please be careful at your work. Please be careful with your work, what you're doing. Someone could be trying to steal your work, what you're doing. Be careful what you're doing, especially with your work, because someone could be trying to steal that. But the outcomes is that, you know, you're going to be the star and success is going to be coming for you. Whatever you decide, whatever relationship, whatever you decide to get in, it's going to be good. Okay. Whatever you decide to get in, it's going to be good. I want to say, I'm wishing you a wonderful month. Kudos to all of you who are receiving your soulmate relationship or good friendships that are coming in. Kudos to all of you. Namaste until next time.